Hello, my name is TheCC. Today I will explain all you need to know about the Wyrm Slayer task. Worms can be found in karuulm Slayer dungeon. Fastest way to get there is by Rada's Blessing teleport. To obtain Rada's Blessing, you will need to have completed Korend and Keba's Heart Diaries at least to have 3 daily teleports to Mount karuulm. And if you want to have unlimited teleport option, you will have to complete the Elite Diary one. I personally have done them and I just love the teleport option. Gets me to the Slayer Master very easily and very fast. If you can't complete none of those tiers in the diary, then another option for you is to use Fairy Rings with code CIR. To use Fairy Rings, you will need to have completed one quest, which is called Fairy Tale 2 Cure a Queen, which is a pretty decent quest, so be prepared to face some challenges. Once you have climbed on the mountain or teleported on it, you will need to head to the middle to get down to the dungeon, then walk west till you will see worms themselves. You can kill them on a Slayer task or without it. And on Slayer task, you can jump on a little island because it will be less crowded and you can kill them in peace. Since we know how to get to worms, I want to explain more about them. To even start killing them, you will need a Slayer level of 62. The worm is a draconic creature with 130 hit points and gives 133.2 Slayer experience once it is killed. They hit with magic and melee, doesn't deal poison, and they can hit up to 13. Worms can be assigned by 4 Slayer Masters, Childer, Conor, Neve and Duradel. As well, you don't need any Dragonfire protection against them. As well, I recommend to unlock bigger and better perk from a Slayer Master shop for 150 Slayer points. It unlocks a superior version of monsters which have a really nice drop table. You can get an imbued heart, dust battle staff, mist battle staff, and eternal gem. I think imbued heart is around 30 million at the moment, and the eternal gem is around 7 to 8 million GP. Really, really nice drops from these monsters. Talking about Worm Superior, you will need to pray anti magic against him and watch your hit points, and that's pretty much all. It's not very strong superior, so don't be afraid to fight him. He will have 320 hit points and will give you an extra 3520 Slayer experience, which is really nice bonus for your Slayer experience. Average superior worm kill is worth around 64k GP, so that's pretty good drop. Okay, let's talk about the gear. Since worms are draconic creatures, I highly recommend to bring Dragon Hunter Lance if you want to kill them with melee, or Dragon Hunter Crossbow if you are planning to kill them with range. I suggest just to kill with melee because it's much faster. With these weapons you will have more accuracy and damage, with Lance 20% increase and with Crossbow 30% increase in damage and accuracy. I recommend this gear, bring Lance, or if you can't afford it, a whip, it will do fine as well. A good option is to bring a stab weapon like a Zamorokian Hasta. It will be a little bit better than a whip, but not much, guys, so a whip is a decent option as well. Proselyte armor for prayer bonus, Slayer helm, ferocious gloves or barrows will do just fine, amulet of torture or fury, primordial boots if you have done the elite kebos and the Koran diary, if not then brimstone boots or granite boots will be a good option as well, berserker ring or any ring you can afford for strength bonus, fire cape or obsidian cape, and you are ready to fight the worms. For the inventory, bring 8 prayer potions, 1 super combat potion, runes to cast high alchemy. I personally bring rune pouch and stock it with fire, law and dust runes, and bring nature runes in the inventory. If you don't have the rune pouch, then just store them in your inventory. Herb sack if you have one, because they drop quite good herbs. Seed box as well will be a good choice to bring since they drop some seeds. Bone crusher and the rest of inventory will be sharks or your best food. As well, leave one spot free since you will need space to store your loot. And there you have it, you are ready to fight worms. Worms are known to drop items such as dragon sword, dragon harpoon, dragon knives, dragon throne axes. The best drop from the drop items are the dragon harpoon. At the moment, you can sell it for more than 800k, which is really nice. I have gotten a few of those and it was pretty awesome to get a drop like that. Another loot is basic runes, rune items, herbs, seeds, coins and so on. As well, you can expect to get 1 in 80 a brimstone key, so every task you should come with 2 brimstone keys, which are around extra 200 KGP. It will be more than enough for your prayer potion and food supplies. I hope that you enjoyed this short Wyrm Slayer guide, and if you did, consider liking this video, subscribing for future uploads, and as always guys, have a nice day!